Gary Burke says, is this why you're pushing the IBC concept generating compound interest daily? I see the light now. Cool. When you say generating compound interest daily with life insurance and high cash value, you get paid dividends once a year, right? And that money is not getting taxed. There's no annual fee. There's no maintenance fee. It's just premium, paying for life insurance, and then having your cash value and whatever term life expense is in there, right? You have that. You don't have to worry about paying taxes because the money is going into a tax-free account. It's considered tax deferred, but when you use it in terms of policy loans or even withdrawals of what your principal was, that money does not get taxed, right? And in addition to all of that, cash value growing, guess what else is growing? The death benefit. So you end up with a much higher death benefit than what you started with. So take me for example, 24 years old, I started my policy at age 23. My death benefit is $4 million right now, but when I'm 90 something years old, my death benefit will be $15 million plus. And that's if I just fund it for 7 years. So I'm funding it for just 7 years, putting in $70,000 a year, right? That's $490,000 in principal. And you mean to tell me that I'll end up in my 90s with over $15 million in death benefit, and I'll have whatever I have in cash value to actually use to my advantage. And then if I have any other sources of income, guess where all that money is going? I'm borrowing from the cash to live off of, to pay things, to invest. And then when cash flow comes in, it sits in the policy. It'll restore the policy. It'll just keep restoring the policy loans. So I'll probably have money borrowed out, but then money's also going back in. So it functions like my own personal bank, my own checking account. So yes, in a nutshell, I share the IBC concept. I think it works great in terms of velocity banking and infinite banking together. And then when you mesh 10X all around that, I mean, now I have real estate accounts and I have Forex and stocks and any other type of investment account that I would want to create. Maybe I put my money with a hedge fund. Maybe I'll play with a Roth, a self-directed Roth account. You know, maybe I'll play with an HSA, whatever it is. I mean, once you 10X, you have options. But as long as you get the fundamentals down of where my money should be and how I can multiply it, oh my goodness, you are on a roll at that point.